Here's my latest thrift store find. This is just going to be a quick video because I'm in the middle of a major MicroMV and mini DV video conversion project for a client. I got 26 MicroMV tapes and 2 mini DV tapes to convert. Those are the ones I've done so far. Got one camcorder capturing video right now on this computer, and on this computer I'm converting the captured video into MP4 files using Handbrake. So that's going to take quite a while, but for now I'll just do a quick video about this. I found this for $20 at the thrift store today. It's a Sony Handycam DCR-TRV250 Digital8 with USB streaming, steady shot, and night shot. This is a more basic model, so it cannot play analog Hi8 or Video 8 tapes, and it can also not do analog video capture. When I open this door, you'll see these jacks are just video outputs, they're not inputs. Also got it with the remote for another $2. I looked all over the store for the power supply or the battery, but I didn't find them, so I did not get them with that, but I have extras on hand, so I just popped in one of my batteries. It was also missing the lens cap, but I have an extra for that as well. As the typical signs of heavy use, including the paint being rubbed off here and some of the buttons being mashed in a little bit, but they still work. I did test this, and also the typical vinyl coming off the hand strap, which is very common on these Handycams. The most interesting thing about this camcorder is the tape that it came with. If I pop that open and wait for it to eject, you'll see it says Peter Frampton. And indeed, it is a recording of Peter Frampton in concert from 2006. It's a bit shaky because it was just a handheld camera footage, but I think it's pretty interesting and worth saving, so I'll definitely be converting that onto my computer and possibly uploading it on my music channel, depending if the copyright system detects it or not. I can go into camera mode here. And the only thing wrong with this camcorder is that the built-in speaker doesn't work. So for example, when I go into the menu here, you don't hear the beeps, even though I have them turned on in the menu. And when I go into playback mode and start the playback, you don't hear anything, even though the volume's turned all the way up. But that is Peter Frampton there. And if I hit the data code on a remote, you can see it was recorded July 30th, 2006. So maybe I'll try to look up online, see where he was in concert on that date, see if there's any record of it. So I'll be capturing that onto my computer. And I think that was a pretty good deal for 20 bucks. The Sony DCR-TRV250 Digital8 Handycam camcorder from 2003. Since my other machines are busy with my MicroMV conversion project, I pulled out this old hunk of junk that is all beat up and missing a key and worn out touchpad and everything, and the screen hinge is broken on that side, but still works perfectly, and it has a firewire port built in, so it's perfect for capturing DV video. And you don't need a very powerful computer to do that. This is only a single core AMD. And you can see it's coasting along at about 18%, around 18 to 20% CPU load. And it's not dropping any frames, so it's doing a perfect job capturing video. And on July 30th, 2006, Peter Frampton was at the Quick Check Festival of Ballooning in Reddington, New Jersey. So that's where this was recorded. And I might as well also mention that I was able to find another one of these laser line 100 cassette racks. I found it for $3 at the thrift store. And here are the cassettes that will be going in it. I've been going through and labeling them with my P-Touch. So I've been quite busy with that. I even had to buy a new label tape because it ran out. So I still have a couple more to go through because these are just the ones I already knew what was on. But these cassettes here are not properly labeled. So see, for example, I had a Commodore 16 program on this and I recorded over it with music, and I need to go through and at least get some sort of record of what's on that tape and so on and so forth. This one doesn't even have any labels on it. And here is just my collection of blank tapes, including my one and only metal cassette. First and only one I've ever owned, and it's not even opened out of the package yet. So maybe one of these days I'll make a video of opening this and recording something onto this and comparing how it sounds compared to a normal Type 1 cassette. For example, one of these really cheap Kmart cassettes. They're so cheap they don't even come with a case for them. It's just in a bag. And since we're talking about cassettes and tapes in general in this video anyway, here are some 4-track cartridges I found at the thrift store. These are basically the same thing as the cart tapes used by radio stations. The same kind of mechanism. So I don't have anything to play these with, and last time I looked on eBay, the few 4-track players available are all way overpriced. Same thing with cart machines. Radio stations in the 90s and 2000s were throwing those things out by the truckload, but now you can't even find them, and the ones you can find are all overpriced. So I probably won't be playing these anytime soon.
All of my tapes are tapes. I suggest that you each the tape in its entirety.